Longest eye bracket ever. Jesus Christ.
What's up, world? How you guys doing?
Okay, wait. Start over.
Angelica says to start over. Week 6. Boom.
This week was busy. I'm exhausted, but happy. We're up in Orange County at Vinny's parents' house right now, and they live, we're flying out of LA, so they're right in the middle, so it just seemed right to come up this way and spend the last couple days. So we're closer, we can do laundry and settle and pack and keep it mellow for the kids and get some real good home-cooked meals. That's the best part about being at Vinny's parents' house. This is mom makes everything from scratch. On Tuesday, we came home from AZ, which was amazing, and we checked into the La Jolla Shores Hotel, one of my faves. I've never personally stayed there, but it is our favorite beach to go to. So we are there all summer long. San Diego natives, La Jolla Beach is the best. This hotel is right on the beach and we just had a blast.
To get up off the floor, move your dancing feet. Do you feel your music, or do you feel it inside? I got the rocking and the rolling, everything gonna be just
remember what just happened.
I lost my horse tooth.
No way, let me see. What happens now?
The tooth fairy comes.
And what does she do?
She gives me something.
And what does she take?
She takes my tooth.
Oh, what do you think she's going to give you?
Maybe a couple of hours. Maybe something like that.
That'd be cool. Can you smile again? Did it hurt, Cash?
No.
Were you scared?
It felt good.
How did it come out?
I just pulled it.
You just pulled it out?
Yeah. Whoa. I twisted it and pulled it.
Whoa.
Twist. Vinny had to work most of the time. He had to tie up some loose ends to get ready for our big trip. And I was with the kids, and we just did pool beach for 2 days straight. And it was awesome because it was so convenient, and I never left. I didn't even use my car for 2 whole days.
Yeah, I mean, the hotel, like she said, is so convenient. You walk out onto the beach, one of the best beaches in San Diego. There's a huge park for the kids within walking distance, restaurants, shops. You really have no reason to leave once you get there. And the hotel, it's been around, I think, since the 70s, and it's got this really cool vintage feeling to it. Really well maintained, but kind of feels like you've stepped back in time when you stay there.
Totally. A lot of character.
For sure.
Super cute.
Food at the restaurant's super good. We ate there a bunch of times.
The best part is when you're at the beach, you like go up to the front and you tell them you're going down to the beach, and they bring out umbrellas and chairs, boogie boards. If you have kids, you don't have to do anything. Yeah. So it's awesome, especially because I was by myself for those couple days. It was awesome to not have to like think about
things. Tell them about the barbecue.
Oh, so we did this really, they offer this really cute beach barbecue, and you get to pick from a menu, like appetizers, entrees, dessert, everything, the whole shebang. And they set it up for you right on the beach, and you get to have it raw or prepared. And we chose to do it raw for the experience of cooking with the kids. I wanted it prepared.
She doubted my barbecue skills.
I didn't know you knew how to barbecue. Have you ever barbecued lobster?
It was my first time barbecuing lobster.
Exactly. It was really good. But did you have to like YouTube it or Google it?
There might have been a little YouTubing involved.
Yes. It ended up being really good, but I was surprised that he wanted to do that. I'm more of a, let's just have it delivered. And done.
It was super fun. The kids liked it. They run marshmallow kits. We got to roast marshmallows.
Watch the sunset. It was gorgeous.
Yeah. It was awesome.
Also this week, the craziest thing was when we were at that hotel is I realized how many amazing people we're going to meet on this journey. And I don't think I realized that just like being in different places and just experiencing and seeing different people. And at that hotel, I met an amazing woman, and she ended up hanging out with us the whole time. And the kids loved her, and she was just like a beautiful soul. And it was one of the first I know of many, and that like really made me excited.
Just encouraging.
Right? Encouraging, and just like all the people we meet along the way. It's so inspiring and awesome.
For sure. So I totally agree. After the La Jolla Shores Hotel, we were able to stay at the San Diego Hilton Resort and Spa. It's located right in Mission Bay in one of the most popular areas of San Diego. And the hotel itself was awesome. Again, I had work I had to get done, and Angelica was with the kids and a lot of our friends for the last couple of days. What did you think of the hotel?
Honestly, when I pulled up, I was like, okay, this will be cool. After coming from La Jolla, I was like, it had so much to offer, the beach and the pool, that I knew we probably wouldn't be playing at the bay. We'd probably mostly be at the pool. But once you walked into the property, like through the lobby, it was like paradise.
Saturday morning and it's time to go. One of these could be the days, but who could have known? Loading in the back of a pickup truck, riding with the boys and pushing the luck, singing songs loud on the way to the game, wishing all the things could still be the same. China someone's over the backstop, Kakua on the ball and soda pop. Well, we used to laugh a lot, but only because we thought that everything good always would remain. Nothing gonna change, there's no need to complain. Sunday morning and it's time to go. Been raining all night so everybody knows. Over to the field for taco football. Big hits, big hats, yeah, give me the ball. Rain is pouring, touchdown scoring. Keep on rolling, never boring. We're talking kind of funny from helium.
It felt like I'd never been in there. Like, felt like you were not in San Diego. It felt like you were on a tropical island with palm trees everywhere and a kid's pool, zero entry. It was beautiful. And a view of the bay, which is obviously gorgeous. And again, I didn't use a car for 2 days. Got to play tourist in our own city for our last few days here in San Diego, and it was so fun. And we invited all our friends and family down, so it felt like a big vacation at home. I loved it.
Yeah.
Just doing what like San Diego's all about. Beach, bay, pools.
Yeah.
Sun. We had so much fun.
For sure. And again, the hotel was super nice. Room was nice. Big spacious room, so all of us fit in there no problem. Restaurant was good. Food was good. What do you think is the hardest thing about this thing so far? I think I know what it is for you, but what do you think it is?
Leaving our friends and family, for sure. I had no idea it would be this hard, honestly. Not that, I don't know, maybe I didn't think about it as much. And then life happens, and your friends and your family, I have kids, my friends have kids, people work.
You get busy.
We get busy. And I talk to all my friends and family all the time, but seeing everybody is a different story. It's hard. And I think because everyone knew we were leaving, obviously we all made a huge effort to spend as much time with our friends and family these last few weeks as possible. And it made it worse, honestly. It was like amazing to be with all my friends and family like every single day. Somebody was with me, and I got to spend quality time. We both did. But it almost would have been easier if it was just how it was before life, you know, where you saw people twice a month or something like that. But it was like,
it's just hard. Very emotional, right? Was it way more emotional than you thought it would be?
Way more than I thought. And I think because we got so saturated with so much friends and family and love and support, and everyone came to play and all the kids were together, and then I just feel like it just got ripped all away.
Yeah, it almost makes you not question what we're doing, but just miss it. I think up until now it's been all pure excitement and anticipation. And then as it gets really close, you have that feeling of, oh man, I'm not going to see these people for a really long time. And, you know, the people you love the most are, you know, you're not going to see them for a while. And you don't know when. You don't know when the next time you might see them.
Yeah.
And their kids are going to get bigger and all that. And, you know, but you know they love you, and you know that you'll pick up right where you left off, without a doubt.
Totally. It's like not saying goodbye, but see you later. And it was way, way harder than I thought. I didn't realize how many people would be so sad to see us go. Like, I knew people would be sad, but I didn't know. Part of me feels guilty and sad.
For sure. And I think that's just, you know, that's part of this process and part of what we're going through and learning and living. And, you know there's going to be ups and downs through this, and this is one of the downs, and it's going to be followed by lots of ups. What else is going on?
Also makes you force you to realize how important, as you get older, like, your core friendships and like, there's not a lot of time for people, or what am I trying to say?
Life goes fast.
Yeah.
And it's easy to get busy and not make the time.
I think we were both like, God, why didn't we spend more? Like, why didn't we do this more? Like, just all get together and have a beach day, or just all get together at night and have a barbecue. And I think when we come back, or it'll, things will be different.
For sure. You'll definitely make more time. Make it a priority. The only things we have left are our cars. I'm selling our cars.
To Tomorrow,
which is crazy. The last thing we have, really, the last real big thing is selling our cars. Other than that, we're just organizing and going through suitcases. Angelica is buying a few last minute things for the trip. Downsizing so that everything fits. We're still shaving off a few things here and there to make sure it all fits.
I feel like every spot that we've been to this last week, I've left something.
Yeah.
Like, we don't need this anymore.
For sure.
We don't need this clothes anymore.
We're kind of just shedding little by little over the last couple weeks. And we're gearing up for a big 24-hour flight. That's going to be real interesting. So tonight, Angelique and I are just going to pack a bunch more, organize, get things geared up. We're working on some travel itinerary stuff, figuring out where we're going. But Bali for the next 5 weeks, we cannot wait to show you guys what we get into. We don't even know what it's going to be, but we know it's going to be awesome.
Show you guys how I'm going to gear up for a 24-hour flight with 3 kids.
Yeah.
What we're taking, the activities we have. We honestly...
So this is our last video from the U.S. The next one you guys see will be in Bali.
Can't believe it.
Can't wait. We're so excited. It's going to be amazing. Please make sure to send us any suggestions, questions, anything you guys want to know more about or think we should check out. Please send our way. Don't forget to subscribe and follow us on Instagram.
Peace out.
Deuces.